Actually, you know, what are some terms you guys, your field, the scientists use for these items that I only have this one word for, and it's such an antiquated term in my mind?
I think what happens with any emerging technology is everyone is figuring it out at the same time. So the terminology tends to be in flux and it tends to change. The most common term that's used is exoskeleton, but we also use the term exosuit to refer to soft exoskeletons.
Right.
Or you might think of exosuits as exomuscles or exotendons as opposed to skeletons.
Wow.
So as an example, we developed a 3-pound exosuit, a soft system using elastic bands. And when you bend or you go down to lift, it's a 3-pound suit, but it takes over 100 pounds of strain off your back by acting like an artificial set of back muscles.
Wow.
We call it an exoskeleton because that's the broad category that's defined. But really, it's more like an exomuscle or an artificial set of muscles that just allow the suit to do some of the work and allow your body to do a little bit less to help reduce the wear and tear on your back and reduce your risk of injury.